The first Olympic Games were held in Greece in 1896 and have been held every 4 years since, except in 1916, 1940, and 1944, due to a few pesky world wars. While athletes have gotten stronger and faster in those 120 years, the core of most events haven't really changed. The winner of the 1896 400-meter race, American Herbert Jameson, finished in 54.2 seconds. 120 years later in Rio, Wade Van Niekerk from South Africa won in 43 seconds. In those 120 years, Olympians managed to shave 20% off their times. But they were still running around an oval track, using mostly the same running technique humans had been using for millennia, ever since they first stood on 2 feet. But one Olympic event that has seen a total transformation in how it's done is the high jump. The high jump was one of the 43 events from those original Olympics back in 1896. For nearly the first 100 years of the event, runners took one of a few styles to clear the bar. The straddle. The Western roll. The Eastern cut. Or the scissor jump. But in 1968, at the Mexico City Olympic Games, 21-year-old Oregonian Dick Fosbury would make history when he jumped 7 feet 4 and a quarter inches above the ground, the first American to win gold in the event in over a decade. But Fosbury wouldn't become famous for his gold-winning jump. In fact, it was still 6 inches below the world record at the time. But Fosbury would become famous for his unique style that would come to be known as the Fosbury flop, where a runner turned away from the pole, jumped and arched their back over the pole head first. Fosbury's style would become legendary and would revolutionize the event. At the next Olympic Games 4 years later, the new Fosbury flop had already become the most commonly used technique among the 40 competing Olympians. And of the 44 Olympic gold medalists to compete in the high jump from 1972 through 2016, 42 used the flop, including all the new world record setters. Today, it remains the most popular technique in modern high jumping. But how does the Fosbury flop actually work? And what's the physics behind this game-changing move? It lies in the center of mass. For every object, we can locate the average position of all its mass by taking into account how the mass is spread out around the object. For instance, the center of mass of a sphere is right where you would expect, at the center point. We humans also have a center of mass. When most people stand up, their center of mass is around their stomach. But what happens to your center of mass when you lift your hands in the air, and maybe even wave them around like you just don't care? Well, your center of mass moves upwards, and when you bend forward, your center of mass moves below your stomach, in a place where there's no mass at all. And this is the trick that the Fosbury flop takes advantage of. The jumper runs in a curved path, allowing them to turn their back to the pole right as they jump, diverting their horizontal velocity to vertical velocity. And as the jumper arches their back, their center of mass bends below the bar. With the old pre-Fosbury techniques, the jumper had to apply enough force to lift their center of mass above the bar by at least a few inches in order to clear it. The Fosbury flopper didn't have to do that. With it, the jumper can apply the same amount of force, but clear a bar much higher, since you don't need to bring your whole body above the bar at the same time. This also means that you can raise the bar so high that even if you can't raise your center of mass any further, like by having a more powerful jump, you can learn to arch your back more effectively to clear an even higher hurdle. With this, the Fosbury flop might be the high jumping world's greatest leap forward, by being a leap backwards. If you like getting smarter with us, make sure to subscribe so you never miss an upload. And remember, there's always more to learn.